Hi, thank you. Would you like to apologize for
yes,
mispronouncing my name?
I'm sorry. See, I told you guys I was going to mess it up. I messed up your name. It's Amy Acker, not Acker.
And she joins us now. She plays Caitlin Strucker, or is it Strucker? No, I'm just kidding. On the new Marvel series, The Gifted.
On the show, she and her family go on the run after finding out her kids possess mutant powers. Here she is asking her brother for help.
To go to jail for even letting you through the door.
When Mom was sick, I left you alone. I knew you didn't like seeing her like that, and I never asked for help. But now I am asking.
I gotta consider my family.
My children. My husband, they are your family, too.
You can stay the night, okay? I've got cash in the safe. You can have it. You can have all of it, okay? But in the morning, you gotta go.
Well, that is going to make for a very awkward Thanksgiving dinner table.
Very dramatic.
By the way, can I just tell you, I used to have nails before I started watching the show. They're all bitten off.
It's
like,
so
see, everybody's chasing one another. There's crazy things chasing
you. And it just started, folks, so if you haven't started watching it yet, you can easily go on Hulu, right, and pull it up. And the second episode aired last night, but it was past our bedtime.
I didn't see it, so no spoilers.
Okay, no spoilers.
But I got to tell you, I read these reviews, right? I read reviews before I watch a new show because there's so many good shows out there. Mm-hmm. You're getting rave reviews, and they're saying that unlike some of the other Marvel reboots or X-Men copies or Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. or whatever, that this one actually hits the mark. How do you feel about that?
We're all so excited to be part of this X-Men universe anyway, and Marvel and all of that, and then it's fun to be on a show that has a little bit different spin on it because we do have this family element, and like we were talking before, I have an 11 and 12 year old, and it's something we can all watch together, which is really exciting. We shoot in Atlanta, but since I was here last night, we got to watch it all on the couch together.
And it's serious action. We're talking serious, like films.
It's Bryan Singer.
I know. Yeah.
Bryan Singer actually directed the pilot episode, right?
Exactly.
So you had him to kind of pull from. Did he tell you anything about your character that you were like, oh, okay, or the X-Men world in general?
He knows everything. About X-Men, and the family are not characters from the comics, so there are some characters that are pulled directly from the comics that people are gonna, you know, little Easter eggs that come up along the way, and then our characters are new for the series.
So, and I was just saying, it's not just Bryan Singer. You pulled the A-team to put this thing together. There's Bryan Singer, there's Lauren Donner from X-Men Apocalypse, there's Simon Kinberg from X-Men Apocalypse.
Everybody.
You know, all these, there's like 10 people that have worked on different Marvel movies.
I know, they know everything.
If they screwed this up, they'd be out of the business.
And I have a dumb question. I do. It's going to be dumb. But how do two humans have a mutant? Because you and your husband, played by Stephen Moyer.
Yes.
Are you telling me you're a
mutant?
I'm
going to say you're going to have to watch.
Wait a minute.
Find out.
I saw something in her eyes.
Something tells me.
Because sci-fi, it can all change, right? Like you start out being human, but then that
anything
old dormant
can happen.
Gene in there.
Yeah.
I don't think you get it from touching doorknobs.
No.
So we're going to check your genetic pool in just a little bit. No, but how much fun is it to shoot an action series? Have you ever done anything like this that's so physical before?
You know, I've mostly done sci-fi genre TV. I was on Person of Interest before this, so I've killed a lot of people on TV, I guess.
Yes!
Fakely. But yeah, it's really fun. It's fun to be the human in this mutant world and kind of get to see it from the audience perspective of watching these people shoot lasers out of their hands and jumping through portals and everything else.
It's incredible. And speaking of all that sci-fi, you went to Comic-Con, right?
We
you
did.
Just get back from
we
Comic-Con?
Just got back.
How
yeah,
was
it was this weekend.
You?
It's so fun.
It's awesome.
Especially after the show already being out and getting to have that interaction with the fans, and I mean, people were so excited about it, and it's really,
you have to believe in yourself after you leave that because the fans are absolutely
so
over
great.
The top, right?
They know more about your show than you do,
sure,
right? It's crazy.
You're married to an actor, too.
I am.
So, how do you work that out now that you have a regular series? How do you make him do more stuff at home?
Well, he's fantastic, and he's great with doing that, and he's also on the Blacklist.
There's a picture.
We kind of go back and forth.
Yeah, have heard of that
and
show.
And switch it off, so it's good.
Yeah, it's been on for a minute or two.
Yeah.
All right, we so enjoyed having you, and I cannot wait to watch episode 2.
Thank you.
Watch it tonight together.
Let's do it. Thanks a lot, Amy Acker. Wishing you the best of luck. The Gifted airs Mondays at 9, right here on Fox.